realizing the need for forging a symbolic, symbiotic relationship between Karnataka and its diaspora, our government has set up non-resident Indian forum in Karnataka, which has been playing a pivotal role in strengthening linkages between Karnataka diaspora and several organizations spread across the globe, besides motivating them to bring in investments to the state. I'm glad to share with you that we have announced the NRI policy of Karnataka just 2 days ago with a vision to play a catalytic role in achieving sustainable linkages between the state and non-resident Karnatakas and non-resident Indians across the globe, so that a progressive, prosperous, robust, and vibrant Karnataka is built. The recent unpleasant incidents in Bengaluru concerning assaults on women have been viewed very seriously, and government is committed to bring to book the perpetrators of these kinds of heinous crimes. Ensuring safety and protecting the dignity of women remains our topmost priority. Effective steps are being taken to increase the rate of conviction in such cases. I would like to draw the kind attention of the Honorable Prime Minister to the resolutions passed in the Global Convention of the Global Organization of People of Indian Origin held in Bengaluru on January 6th, seeking extension of time till December 30th, 2017 for NRIs and PIO to exchange and or deposit high denomination specified bank notes in Reserve Bank of India or State Bank of India.